So the boyfriend said, "Let's go for a drive. We can spend some time alone together." His girlfriend agreed, so they set off down a lonely country road and were soon far away from any houses and got deeper into remote bushland. Suddenly, the car hit a log falling across the middle of the road. The couple were startled when the car jolted to a stop. They had not seen the log in time. The boyfriend said, "I'd better take a look to see if there's any damage." The girlfriend shivered with apprehension as it was so dark outside. "Be careful," she exclaimed. After a while, the boyfriend came around to the window. "The log we hit has damaged the car badly, and we won't be able to drive it. I only need some help to fix it. I thought I saw a light on a few miles back, so I will go and see if I can get help." His girlfriend said, "No, it's too dangerous." He replied, "Don't worry, I'll be fine. Anyway, we have no choice." The girl said, "I'm coming with you." "No, you stay here and lock all the doors, and no matter what, promise me you won't get out of the car." The girl felt very fearful, but agreed to do as he said. More than an hour passed, and the boyfriend had not returned. The girl began to worry and thought about getting out to go look for her boyfriend. Then she remembered the promise she made to him and decided to wait a bit longer. She put on the radio to try and take her mind off the rising fear she felt. The only station she could pick up was a boring local country station. She listened to a few songs, and then a news broadcast came on. There was a story about an escapee from a local lunatic asylum. People were warned to lock all the doors, as this deranged escapee was considered extremely dangerous. The girl became even more fearful, but decided to stay put and wait for her boyfriend. She must have dozed off, for she was awoken by a loud tap, tap, tap on the roof of the car. Startled, she looked out the windows to see if her boyfriend returned, but could see nothing but darkness. The sound came again, tap, 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 and she wondered what could be causing it. Too fearful from the events which had passed that evening, she could not bring herself to get out to see what it was. The noise continued, tap, tap, tap. This went on for some time. Suddenly, she was blinded by harsh light and could see headlights shining through the front windscreen. She hesitated, wondering if it was safe to get out when she heard a voice over a megaphone. "You, in the car. I want you to listen very carefully. I want you to slowly get out of the car and come towards me. I'm a police officer, and it is very important you do exactly what I say. You are in danger. You must get out of the car immediately and slowly walk over here. But whatever you do, don't turn around and don't look back." She heard the noise again. Tap, tap, tap. Shaking with horror, she slowly opened the car door. She climbed out of the car. The policeman said, "That's it. Now walk towards me without any sudden movement. And remember, whatever you do, don't look back." She quickened her pace as she got close to his car. And as she almost reached the officer, she couldn't help herself and turned around. And there, on the roof of the car, was a bent over figure of a man holding a stick. Only the stick she saw, to her great horror, her boyfriend's severed head, and the figure was banging it on the roof. Tap, tap, tap. The cell phone. A couple of months ago, my friend's cousin, a single mother, bought a new cell phone. After a long day of work, she came home, placed her phone on the counter, and went to watch TV. Her son came to her and asked if he could play with her new phone. She told him not to call anyone or mess with text messages, and he agreed. At around 11:20, she was drowsy, so she decided to tuck her son in and go to bed. She walked to his room and saw that he wasn't there. She then ran over to her room to find him sleeping in her bed with the phone in his hand. Relieved, she picked her phone back up from his hand to inspect it. Browsing through it, she noticed only minor changes, such as a new background, banner, etc. But then she opened up her saved pictures. She began deleting the pictures he had taken, until only one new picture remained. When she first saw it, she was in disbelief. It was her son sleeping in her bed. But the picture was taken by someone else above him, and it showed the left half of an elderly woman's face. This new, old house. We bought an old house, my boyfriend and I. He's in charge of the new construction, converting the kitchen into the master bedroom, for instance, while I'm on wallpaper removal duty. The previous owner papered every wall and ceiling. Removing it is brutal, but oddly satisfying. The best feeling is getting a long peel, similar to your skin when you're peeling from sunburn. I don't know about you, but I kind of make a game of peeling, on the hunt for the longest piece before it rips. Under corner section of paper in every room is a person's name and a date. Curiosity got the best of me one night when I googled one of the names and discovered the person was actually a missing person. The missing date matching the date under the wallpaper. The next day, I made a list of all the names and dates. Sure enough, each name was for a missing person with dates to match. We notified the police, who naturally sent out the crime scene team. I heard one tech say, "Yep, it's human. Human. What's human? Ma'am, where is the material you removed from the walls already? This isn't wallpaper you were removing."